Bel Air's weather underground radicals who don't think they bombed enough. I'm seeing moveon.org, who says, "General, betray us." And I'm seeing you go to a Daily Coast convention. And this week, Daily Coast came out and said that Sarah Palin's Down syndrome baby was birthed by her 15-year-old with no proof. They put that on there. And I'm going, gee, that Barack Obama, he's got some pretty bad friends.
All right, well,
am I wrong?
You are wrong. Let's start from scratch. Number one, I know thousands of people, right? And so, understandably, people will pick out folks who they think they can support.
I don't know anybody like that. And I know thousands of people. I don't know anybody like that.
Well, hold on a second. Let me make my point now. The right thing we've talked about. Look, I joined a church to worship God, not a pastor. This whole notion that he was my spiritual mentor and all this stuff, this is something that I've consistently discussed. I had not heard him make the offensive comments that ended up being looped on this show constantly. And I was offended by them, and ultimately
it led to... You never heard those comments?
I hadn't heard those
comments.
He was
selling them in the lobby at a church.
What can I tell you?
How many times did you go to church a month?
You know, I probably go twice a month.
And he never said inflammatory stuff?
He didn't say stuff like that, all right?
Did he say white people were bad?
No. What he said was racism was bad.
But not white people are bad.
There was no doubt that what he said was racism was bad. The relationship was ruptured. I'm not a member of the church.
Right.
In both his case and Father Flager's case, they've done great work in the community. And I worked in some very poor communities. That's how I got to know these folks, because I was working in these neighborhoods. Now, on this Ayers thing, which you've been hyping Bill pretty good.
Not that much. But Woods Foundation board.
Here's the bottom line. Yes. This guy did something despicable 40 years ago.
You know, he did despicable last week. He said he didn't do enough bombings. That's last week.
I haven't seen the guy in a year and a half.
But you know who he was. He's on the Woods Foundation board.
Let me finish my point, all right? Here's a guy who does something despicable when I'm 8 years old.
Okay.
All right? I come to Chicago. He's working with Mayor Richard Daley, not known to be a radical. So he and I know each other as a consequence of work he's doing on education. That is not an endorsement of his views. That's not
me. No, but you guys partnered up on a youth crime bill. You remember that?
And it was a good bill.
No, it wasn't. That bill said that if a youth commits a second violent felony, he does time in an adult prison. That's two shots. You said no. You know the south side of Chicago. You know how many people are hurt.
Listen, you're absolutely right. My community gets hit by crime more than anyone
else. And I'm right on that bill. You were wrong on that bill.
I disagree with you on that bill. We're getting too far afield here.
That's important, though. You and Ayers were allied on that bill.
No, look, he didn't write that bill.
No, he was supporting it, and so were you. But you guys were together.
Hold on a second. Now we're getting...
If that's unfair, I'm sorry.
That's pretty flimsy. Here's the point, right? This guy is not part of my campaign. He's not some advisor of mine. He is somebody who worked on education issues in Chicago that I know. The problem that your viewers, your guys, that your folks, the folks you champion, the problem you're going through, the problems they're going through with trying to pay their bills, trying to keep their job, trying to move up in this world, their problem isn't Bel Air's. It was Bel Air's 40 years ago.
But
when he was blowing stuff up.
They want a president who they can identify with.
They want a president
that they can identify with.
And they should be able to identify with me, because my story is your story. My story is
your
story.
But your associations are not my associations.
But you move on.
General Betrayus, the Daily Coast.
I was offended by that.
But you said good things about them. You showed up to the Coast convention.
Yeah, but look.
You don't get worse than these.
Hold on a second. I mean, there's a whole bunch of stuff said on Fox about me that is completely biased.
Correct the record.
Well, but I still don't mind coming on your show, just because there are a whole bunch of things that may be said on this network that I completely disagree with. I don't sort of assume that you have to take responsibility for everything that is said on Fox News any more than I would expect you to take responsibility for everything that's said on Daily Coast. Think about it.
Fox News is not hateful. Some of
you were watching Sean Hannity consistently,
he's a commentator.
But that's all these bloggers are. I'm not making an excuse for them.
Hannity's never said he wants Dick Cheney to die of cancer. Hold on a second.
Hold on a second. All I'm saying is, these guys, they've given me a hard time. You know, one of the times they gave me a hard time?
They raised a ton of money for you, sir.
You know one of the times they gave me a hard time? Was when I went to campaign for Joe Lieberman. Now, Joe didn't mention that in his speech the
other night.
They
gave you a hard time about voting for the FISA thing.
Exactly. Well, so it's not, all I'm saying is, I expect to be held responsible for the things I say and do. And one of the things that's happened in this campaign, and I think that you have the power to help correct the record on this, is not to put me in a position where every tangential relationship...
It is. There's a pattern of behavior.
No, there is not a pattern of behavior. It is guilt. It is classic guilt by association.
The pattern of behavior is that you feel very comfortable for some reason in far left precincts. That's the pattern of behavior that I see.
But, Bill, I've got friends who are on the far right.
Who?
I've got colleagues in the Senate.
Give me a name.
Well, no.
I always do that.
Here's what happens: is if I give a name, then the next thing I'll know is people will say they're comparing this friend of his.
You know what I wanted to hear?
Bill Ayers, and I
go golfing with Rush Limbaugh. That's what I wanted to hear there.
All right, tomorrow the.